Just don't give them an easy lane up top, and Soxa and Resolution are having a very difficult time dealing with
that helps.
Double melee lane.
Mu just got time locked on the bottom lane. Combine that with the Fortune's End, Mu's gonna go down. First blood, it goes to Wings.
And on the top lane.
Yeah, Misery's rotating around. Faith so low, Resolution lower. Cold Embrace is still available. Now Misery will arrive. Ice Ice, Bio Strike is just going for the last swing, trying to find Resolution, but these Searing Arrows doing the early damage, the DC required. That arrow fly down, there she is. Resolution will find himself a kill. Well, it will be easy for Mu to deal with that if he was level 6, but doesn't have the Chakram available yet. Another heavy rotation to top, three from either side. They stun on Resolution, Tauren as well. Soxa, he needs to get that Cold Embrace off, but Oracle has more than enough magical damage. Misery with the Burrow Strike forward, wants the Nyx Assassin, doesn't have the damage output, but maybe with the help of the Wyvern, he will have it. Misery to the tree line, the salve is actually gonna get canceled off. It was the Caustic Finale that did it, and now Faith, 28 life, will it be enough? Is he gonna pop? Faith barely survives, dropping down to 8 at one point.
And another tower.
Yeah, without the committal of Exorcism, this is a troubling sight when you can't even hold your tier 1s.
Is really looking for a kill, Epicenter.
With the Timber Chain into Chakram, they commit the Epi too. Innocence will walk into the side of it, but now we can just use Fortune's End. Slow down Misery. It will connect the follow-up stun with the Mana Burns by Carapace. The curse is out. It holds Oracle in, and Mu comes in with a Chakram, but False Promise. It will keep Innocence alive as he TPs himself away to safety. Mu still looking for something. Actually, he's just looking to get the hell out of here. Exorcism is triggered, but the stun is on Mu, and it's going to be Wings holding the Timbersaw in position. No, the chain up. The last attack from the Dead Prophet will find the kill. The support is arrived for DC. They arrive in with a big Searing Arrow damage. Faith makes a break for the tree line. Still alive, triggering Dust 2. So no extra infants for Resolution. Time lock, not gonna be enough from Shadow. As Weeha, Cold Embrace, Resolution, the Torrent is gonna connect the double stun. Faith the end, he walks himself out. He walks over, he wants the last finishing move. He won't get it. Ice will finish him. The Torrent, it may not be done yet. Soxa set up in towards the air. X marks the spot. You ain't going nowhere apart from down to the Briny Deeps. Faith doesn't have enough for the stun. Spike Arrow's up unless she connect over on Misery. He tries to create space. No timer from Shadow. Time will forward. Now he finds the kill. More TP support arriving from DC. Another connected time from Ice Eyes onto Misery. Stuns. Chakra forward. Mu needs to turn the tire. This fires Misery. The one charge will keep him back into it. He can go for another Burrow Strike. It's Mu. Time lock for a century. He wants to walk out to the T1 towers. No stuns available from Nyx Assassin. But these ones really playing dividends.
Oh my goodness, what ungodly teamwork coming out from Wings next to that Saisha.
It's not over yet. Innocence is coming over. The Akrono is on Weeha. Innocence brings the damage. Weeha, he is gonna pop like a top. They look for more. Ice. Where is it? No, the Ice X mark's not gonna hit. They turn around, look to the T1 tower.
I'd like to see some maybe backdooring.
Weeha
Resolution.
Playing stuns by Carapace. Sent instantly back that Starfall of Weeha. Shadow, he's there. Chrono's up. Moonlight Shadow will not protect the Mirana.
No
spells. Now bottom lane, because they found the Death Prophet. But Death Prophet, what? She blinks away. No one attacked her. She just gets her out. She had the Yule Scepter as well. With the Exorcism up, DC was, well, hoping to kill her up before it could do with a lot of damage. Now she'll bring it back over. It's only a little bit longer left on it. Timbersaw up for Faith. Gets the stun. Now the Exorcism goes to work. Misery prepping the Epicenter. Burrow strikes forward. Police going down, but the Fortune's dead! The save is huge! Resolution's time dilation out this fight. Sucks has the TP out, but DC, they're losing everything, including the kitchen sink.
Rotating around, looking for an opening. Middle lane, Blink, Fire Strike, Death Prophet, the arrow will connect. That's a good 5 seconds. Innocence getting ripped apart by Resolution. He still got the False Promise onto Blink, but the life just won't be there. Blink is guaranteed dead when he hits the ground from the damage, and it will happen. Clinks will take the kill. Cold Embrace keeping Misery out. Now it's Faith Bian's turn. Resolution finding a triple kill. Digital Chaos have just pulled out the team fight of their life.
Dewarding happened, so DC definitely know that Wings are around Roshan. They're going to group bump, smoke up. Remember, without the Exorcism, there's not a lot of quick damage arriving from Wings. So Roshan at now 2k life. They're a little bit too far away here, DC. So Roshan will go down to Wings. The question is, they want to keep fighting. Sentries are down. Leap up, looking for the Chrono. Leaps away, however. Timbersaw has the Yule Sash. He gets the Yule Scepter up. He's trying to avoid the time dilation. The Chrono! It got Resolution! That's a big one! They need to find the kill! Ships on the way in, and Resolution crashed on the hull! Soxa also has to Cold Embrace, but there's too much damage there to still find that kill. X-Mark and back. Weeha thought he might get out this one. The epicenter arrives from Misery. Minimal damage. Wings can just tank through it. Misery, silence, nukes. He's got enough life. He's moving north, and will it be enough? While the battle happens in the pit, Misery will die. DC lose four and Wings.
Wow.
The scan comes out from Radiant side. They don't find anyone in Viz. They know the Klinks isn't there, and here they go. Blink triggers the exorcism. Up to the tier 3 tower.
They wanted to be able to spam this with the Timbersaw and the Winter Wyvern, but they're nowhere close as T3's gonna fall before they really get any damage.
Yep, now the jump comes in. Quick chain away, R3 blinks forward, Barrier Strike. It connects with the Death Prophet, the Chrono! Weehara move! Shadow catches two again, the Torrent combo! They move down towards Moon with a double stomp from Faith! They ensure the kill, no buyback available for the Timbersaw! And Klinks is still waiting for an opportunity. Resolution sitting outside the base. He doesn't know where to go. Blink borrow forward. Blink Exorcism wears off however, so all the life kicks back into her misery. Caught out. Another double stun from Faith Bian. Jump forward from Shadow. Looking for the damage and a time lock. First hit on Weeha. This could be it. A triple kill for Shadow. The cast is good, however. Nyxus hasn't been brought down. The arrow flies forward. Misses his target. Resolution needs to pump in more damage. The gem stolen by Shadow as he'll run back out through the front lines. The staff. Dodged by the first Manta, still gonna hit by the secondary one. It's Klinks. Where is this control? Where is this damage? It just isn't there. The silence on Murata means he can't arrow. They see Innocence TPing out. It's gonna be too late. The TP was more than well completed. They do not have a creep wave with them, but they can start a pincer.
Innocence might get picked up by Resolution.
Oh, can they do it? There's a Ghost Scepter. You can't pick off Jack. Yes, he can now. Diffuser Blade is up. Turns it off. The curse. It holds Death Prophet in position. Shadow jumps over, but now he's in range of it. Weeha with the Starfall. Not enough damage. They have to force up back to Winter Wyvern. Away from Blink. Goku's run well off the mark. And well, Misery is the stun there. 1 second, 2 seconds. Shadow double hit. Nice and quick. Finds the pickoff on Misery. All he wanted to do is retreat.
Still alive and healthy on the side of Wings, and with no BKB on Cleeks, they're gonna have to hope for a miracle here.
Exorcism is down, however, a miracle's been eliminated. Move, there goes your Chakram forward. Arrow flies in off target. Nice hit from Weeha, but the better hit from Faith Beyond. He has been godlike this game. Another big stun, Resolution. He'll finally bring down Blink. There is a Spike Carapace available. Resolution, no BKB charge, so he'll stun up himself. Chakram, or you can just Timber Chain into Whirling Death. Gem can be recovered as Move, hot on the tails of Ice. Size. Does he have the damage? Whirling Death, one punch, there it is. Moo gets a double kill, but the damage has been done. A full Raxing on mid and bottom lane done by Wings.
And even that, like, you get an Aghanim Scepter on the Nyx Assassin bottom lane. They initiate Ice Ice, they want the kill. The stun is there on Misery as Yule Set protects Ice Ice again. Misery forced off now. The double ones, DC, they just need a bail out here, but Misery pulled back. Cold Embrace will keep him alive a little bit longer. Barra strikes up for him as the Chrono on the back lines. They found Resolution! It's a big kill! Mooney to turn the damage around. Innocence, he'll be ripped apart by the Shark Group, and he will go down. The curse is too late to take the attention away from Wings, and now Epicenter. Misery will also jump in. Murana dies on the left. Misery, four star down. Shadow, hot on the tails. And Klinks cannot get caught out like that. Like, if they can recover the gem.
I think it's more so like Shadow always finding the right targets with the Chronosphere. He knows that the Klinks is the only one that can really do damage to them. Murana's countered by the Fate's Edict.
That courier has traveled the whole Earth. He's waiting. Drop the TP scroll. Now the courier, all the silence. Yules will dispel. Support's coming over. It's there from the Winter Wyvern. But with the blood, it'll be enough. The Bloodborne Timbersaw. He's not going to pop. They force off him out. Mr. Timberchainer. They pop him. The gems on the ground. And there's no buyback. 80 seconds without the Timbersaw. DC, they're scrambling away. Soxa needs some help. Misery's there, but again with the silence. Four star up. Nice arrow from Wii. Hitting Blink on the back lines. They Barrow Strike forward. Blink is low with a splinter. It's not enough damage. Shadow the Chronosphere. Resolution! He walked into it. The damage is there from Shadow. Resolution is gone. And with him, maybe the host of the game. GG! Wings will take game number two.
What a god on this faceless boy. 20 kills, 0 deaths, perfect Chronospheres. Resolution tried to all in with the rapier at the end, but no death pact. Walking in a Chrono, just a lot of mistakes from DC as they crumble in game number three.
Yeah, the big story is that bottom lane missing of stun after stun. You can see how DC, the smile turns quickly upside down as Wings have a flawless game, and you got to say it. It's the way you do it, non-Melk style. 20-0 on the Faceless Void. The anti-Melk is the Shadow Award. A perfect Faceless Void game from him. A great game from Wings.
Tyranitar top lane.
Ice being cancelled. That's four sticky napalm charges on the Vengeful Spirit. She can't get away from this. There's no extra help. Zux is going to drop right now. Blink burns him, but Misery looking for some revenge. Ice dropping low. Misery void in 3 seconds, 2 seconds. Need to slow him down, stopping the turn rate to Blink.
Definitely going to be happy with that. Like I said, if you can get an image farm, we are trouble in mid lane. Dropping low, he's got Dark Pact available. He's burning out at the moment. Into the tree line, Faith. That's going to get caught in by the creep wave. The attack's from the tower.
Axe, this is going to be an extremely tough. Actually, he has no pounce.
Yeah, he's got Shadow Dance, however. But the stomp, the stun, the magic missile from Sarksko. Will Zep be able to help out enough? Slark, pounce still on cooldown for 4 more seconds. But Moonlight Shadow from Resolution will allow DC to make a break to the tree line. We are. Okay, it looked like he was thinking of turning around and going for another opening. Shadow is fairly low, but it's bottom lane. Innocence, Silent Stump, the Moo whirling deaths him down. Faith looking for a revenge, but it's top lane where they're about to initiate onto Shadow with the Dark Pact and Magic Missile. The Stomp will force him to split, but back on bottom lane, Faith moving back to his own tier 1 tower. Moo body blocking it up. The silence is there. Whirling death. I'll just use Shark from Timber Chain. No, no! Moo goes too far to the side.
Good timing considering how poor the early game was. Misery.
Yeah, they found him out. They push him back, and Misery will burn, or will he? He can't get to the other side of the tree line, but maybe with Batrider caught out. The ET split is coming in. DC need to split. Arrow is not available for the moment. Chakram doesn't actually reach up to Wings, but Weehar is in, and he's looking for the Batrider. The perfect leash. Batrider comes down to the ground as the Firefly will wear off. And so with all of his live faith, a little bit too deep himself. The Chakram flies out, and now it's just fight after fight. Maybe going the way here for DC. Moo goes in deep. Reactive armor charges don't exist for him.
We looking for a weak support like the Keeper of Light. He has scouted out.
Yeah, where is that target? Instead he finds, well, not the targets he wants. He found ET. Cole pulls him back out of it, but the Chakram flies forward. ET, not enough damage to kill him until the Timber Chain from Moo connects. ET splitter well off the mark. And they look for more. The Courier into the tree lines. Blink kept out by Resolution as he's finally rotated up from the mid, but Wings finding back behind the T1 tower. Still another 15 seconds till he's up. That arrow flies 5 seconds on the axe. We pounces over the trees and in comes Moo! They have the damage! Wing goes to their own tier 1 tower, will be slaughtered. Shadow has his Blink available. They need more stuns and the damage. Shadow blinks out, but the iron is killing him off. Shadow will die here. Nothing will stop this. Even the flame break can't buy the space. I'm not quite certain what Resolution's waiting for. He's just sitting in the middle lane for the creep wave to arrive. The call from Faith, the axe. Oh, Batrider gets hit by the arrow. The splitter is good, but then the leap into double starfall. The magical damage is too much for Wings. Moo will survive. He was the one they wanted, and it was Weehar who gets the double kill.
And Gem now goes away of Nightstalker. He almost has his axe and a gem complete. This is disastrous for
Wings. Hunting the kill. Wings actually hunting the kill. He walks up the high ground under the tier 3 towers. He wants Ice. The call of the silence is there for Misery. The arrow will be soaked up by the free wave, but it doesn't matter. Ice is already down.
Well, the arrow misses, trade. But Weehar tracks.
He finds Blink. The pounce forward. Faith gets the call off. You still got a decent amount of essence shifted in Faith. The Blade Mill will protect him. Now Lazsu, they pull Wii in, but he already triggered the Dark Pact, breaking free the Mana Void! Shadow won't be enough! The Swamp Out for Weeha! Pulled back in range of Innocence Mana Leak! A one-for-one trade-off for now. The Culling Blade ensures the kill. The Moo, Timber Chains forward. There was only one tree there for him to work with. He's underneath the range of 2 sentries, but the arrow from Resolution connects on Anti-Mage. Will there be enough damage? He'll blink himself out to safety. DC, not that healthy. Again, this Mana Leak being a pain in the butt. But that's why Yule Scepter up. Timber Chain cancels, a very short one anyway, but Misery moves over. No nighttime available. He's also got the gem. Wings, they'll follow this one to the ends of the earth. The spirit's on top. The split of Misery's got nowhere to go. Stunned up by the Mana Leak. He'll give the gem over to actually no Resolution. I thought they might have done a handoff. Doesn't happen. A Moo dying to Wings. The blink.
Oh,
it gets interrupted. Yule Scepter, he had to take off the burn effect of that flame break up to the trees, but he knows he's dead. Great chase by Wings.
What a flame break right there. He had the observer
on. He's looking to jump out, but he actually gets the blink call over on the Misery. So the jump out, the ET splitter, they really want to get that kill, and they got it. The Vengeful Spirit trying to swap him out. The Moonlight Shadow won't do enough. The Axe finds the kill. Moves some really good damage though with the Shark from, but it's just the last two. Too good for Wings.
They catch out the slot. They get three down. Now they can finish what they started. The death of Roshan.
This Observer Ward saw that Night Stalker. That swap just crushed them as two heroes got hit by the Earth Splitter.
This next defense from DC, it has to work. The arrow, 5 seconds over on the Axe. Resolution jumps in. The double star fall damage. They'll bring down the Axe. So finally they get a small break, but Wings have rotated over the swap, instantly canceling out the lasso. Move! Huge damage! Connell is gone! Ice might join him in a moment as Murata blinks forward. They've got the damage, this could be the fight. We leaping forward, the BKBs break Batrider free. Moves still in the neighborhood shadow. There's your Abyssal Blade, the Mana Void on a resolution. Doing heavy work, but the Shark from doing more of it. Shadow is burning inside of it. The Agency Mortal will trigger. Blinkers away on low life. Do they have enough to kill the anti-Marga once again? He'll blink out. Moostick's with him. Yule Scepter up. Blink off cooldown in 1 second time. Now in comes Blink himself. Flame Break pushing DC away. This will give Shadow just enough space to escape.
BKB is like a free kill on Batrider and or Keeper.
Wings is coming down. They're looking for a kill on Mu. Almost everyone's here apart from the Mirana. She does have BTs, but they can only TP the tier 2 tower. Now Cottle, 2-3. Can't get the 4th hit. The Shark will do the work. Bash forward with the Abyssal. The arrow, it connects on Shadow. 5 seconds stun. The ET Splitter. It's not enough damage yet. Misery's still tanking through all of this. The Mana Void. He wants Misery dead, but the Moonlight Shadow. They don't have the vision at the moment. Mu will go back into the Moonlight Shadow too. Timberchain, 1 second. This will bring him back in range of the tower, unless they want to fight. Arrows off cooldown, blink forward, the arrow will miss. We are waiting. The ninja out from the trees. Faith triggers the blade mail as well as his BKB to pounce forward. Faith getting caught in the back of that. We are explodes to the Mana Void. Luckily for the rest of DC, they weren't in range for it, but the stomp forward from my size can go for the stomp. No real way to get away from this one, especially when you get a pistol blade down by the animage. Move, can't chain away. He'll Yule Scepter up. The blink dagger won't be off cooldown in time, so he just has a suicide when he hits the ground. The blink goes for more, burning up the Vengeful Spirit with the Firefly.
Okay, it is confirmed. Shadow can bash on command. What was that? Right on the Timber Chain, right as when Slark was about to escape. And I talked about it, the Bastion versus BKB. BKB, he would really love to have it for that fight.
Mm-hmm. As they attack into the Tier 3 tower, trying to get that one step closer to the Aegis, as now Timber locked down the double star fall, but Mu is too low. He has Fireback and Bubble. The Culling Blade it out. Slark up, 4 seconds until he's alive. No fortification, arrow, it doesn't connect. Innocence, the horse tail doesn't catch it, the swap out. Saxar again, sacrificing himself just to make sure they can get that double damage out from the Starfall of Resolution. Good stomp, Mu, Yule's up in towards the air. He has a way to get out thanks to Moonlight Shadow. They can play the invis game. Shadow going in very, very deep. Gets the stun over on Misery, but Weeha returns with a bash of his own. And now with a jump out, Resolution leaves the tree line. He is out of mana. He can't get out of this one. He can blink back into the fight in just a moment. Faith BN, so low. Where's the damage from DC? Mu, it's a dieback for him. Shadow's looking for the kill. They found Weeha. The Bass Control is dead! Buyback is available for him though, and he'll need to use it. The rest of DC are dying out in front of their own Tier 3 tower. Resolution back into the fight, but the Culling Blade kills off the Night Stalker, giving Wings the pump up they need to go inside. They look for the lasso and they've got it. It's the Slark. Arrow flies in. It'll be a 5 second stun over on Blink, but Wings, they brought down the melee racks. Shadow, Mana Styles out. Weeha has to bounce himself out of this one. He moves up to the side shop. Shadow's here. Weeha initiates. He needs the kill and get the hell out. One more attack, but he has to bail. 23 HP. Now Weeha. He forced the issue too hard. Will he go down? Yes, he will. 90 seconds. The door has been opened by Weeha's aggressiveness. And Wings, it is a landslide as the grass drop. And they're gonna try and break DC's glass to blink in the lasso! Misery instantly swapped back out again. Shadow's in pretty deep, but he'll come over. Sucks are already on the sidelines. Misery, now he's being controlled. The Abyssal Blade is still up. Misery's gone. The Culling Blade, that could be it right now. DC on the ropes as Wings, they look towards the mid-racks. Bring down the Tier 3 tower. Mu trying to slow it up with a Chakram. Resolution out of arrows and also out of teammates. DC. They have Slark up in 20. They'll have one more opportunity, and that's to defend the Tier 3 racks on top. There it is. The mid, the melee is down. Range racks will follow. Wings, do they play safe? Do they back it up? No! In they go! Resolution! Welcome back and goodbye! You have buyback available, and here comes the push. This is the defense now. DC, you either hold or you die. As Wings, they rip down the tier 3 tower. Weeha wants to go out through the back lines and attack. Now the last two, they found Tuska. Weeha ripped apart the buybacks. It won't be enough. Go Game of Blade. Wings are your international 2016 champions. Terrific display of Dota. You didn't know if it could be perfect in the group stages, but only losing games to GC. Two in total throughout the entire playoff. One to Techies, one with the punch. And now they topple DC in a 3-1 victory here in Key Arena.
Black has to be happy that Anti-Mage is going to be plastered there for a full year.
And we can be as happy as that as Slack's not being on the Aegis. Terrific battle. Big props to Digital Chaos. They overcame so much to get to this point. They played terrific Dota. They made the meta, but Wings broken. To take the championship, to take the biggest trophy in the Dota 2 calendar year.
And finally, they found their consistency in the finest of times. It only matters during this month, Toby.
That's right, the international is the big one. You can win as many majors as you want to, but if you take TI, you become immortal. As Digital Chaos, well deserving of it. Very, very well deserving of their second position.
And now
but
Wings.
It is Wings. They can greet their fans. And they claim what every Dota 2 player wants in their life. The Aegis of the Immortal! It belongs to Wings!
Ladies and gentlemen, the champions of the international! Wings Gaming!
Ladies and gentlemen, the International 2016 champions are Wings Gaming!